Welcome to my podcast. Today I'll be announcing the 2018 NHL All-Star Game selections. I'll be previewing the divisional round playoff in the NFL, and I'll also be talking about disappointing players in fantasy basketball. 2018 NHL All-Star Game selections. Atlantic Division. Forward, Steven Stamkos, Nikita Kucherov, Jack Eichel, Auston Matthews, Aleksander Barkov, and Brad Marchand. Defense, Erik Karlsson, Mike Green, Victor Hedman. Goaltenders, Andrei Vasilevskiy, Carey Price. The coach is Jon Cooper. Metropolitan Division. Forwards, Alex Ovechkin, John Tavares, Taylor Hall, Claude Giroux, Sidney Crosby, Josh Bailey. Defense, Seth Jones, Kris Letang, Noah Hanifin. Goaltenders, Braden Holtby, Henrik Lundqvist. Coaches by Perry Trotz. Central Division. Forwards, Nathan MacKinnon, Blake Wheeler, Brayden Schenn, Erik Staal, Tyler Seguin, Patrick Kane. Defense, PK Subban, John Klingberg, Alex Petrangelo. Goaltenders, Connor Hellebuyck, Pekka Rinne. The coach is Peter Laviolette. Pacific Division. Forwards, Connor McDavid, Johnny Gaudreau, Anze Kopitar, James Neal, Brock Besser, Rickard Rakell. Defense, Drew Doughty, Brent Burns, Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Goaltenders, Jonathan Quick and Marc-Andre Fleury. Coach by Gerard Gallant. Next week, I'll be talking about the Las Vegas Golden Knights' great season. NFL Divisional Round Playoff Preview. I'll be previewing the AFC Divisional Round first. The first matchup will be between the New England Patriots and the Tennessee Titans. That game will be played on Saturday at 8:15 on CBS. Here are my keys to the game. For New England needs to keep their focus and not self-destruct. Tom Brady needs to be good, and the New England defense needs to find a way to slow down Marcus Mariota. For the Tennessee Titans, they need to establish the run game early on. Marcus Mariota needs to play his best game in his young career, and playmakers on defense need to make an impact on the game. My prediction for this game is New England wins 31-21. The other AFC divisional game is between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Jacksonville Jaguars. That game will be played on Sunday at 1:05 p.m. on CBS. Here are my keys to the game. For Pittsburgh, Le'Veon Bell and Antonio Brown need to play like the superstars that they are. Big Ben needs to play like vintage Big Ben, and the Steelers' defense needs to slow down Leonard Fournette. For the Jaguars, Jacksonville's defense needs to play like a top 5 defense in the league. The Jaguars need to double Antonio Brown and force other receivers to do the damage, and Blake Bortles needs to not throw interceptions. My predictions for this game is that the Jaguars pull an upset and win 21-17. In the NFC divisional round, the first game will be between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Atlanta Falcons. That game will be played on Saturday at 4:35 p.m. on NBC. The keys to the game for the Philadelphia Eagles, the Eagles need to establish the run game early on, especially with Carson Wentz injured. The Eagles need to double Julio Jones and force other receivers to do the damage. Nick Foles needs to play like 2013 Nick Foles. For the Atlanta Falcons, Matt Ryan needs to play like the MVP he was last season. Julio Jones needs to take over the game, and the Falcons' defense needs to limit the rushing attack and force Nick Foles to beat them. My prediction is that the Atlanta Falcons win 24-13. The second game will be between the Minnesota Vikings and the New Orleans Saints. That game will be played on Sunday at 4:40 on Fox. Keys to the game for Minnesota. Minnesota's defense needs to have a great pass rush to make Drew Brees uncomfortable. Case Keenum and Adam Thielen need to establish the connection early and often. Vikings defense needs to slow down one of the league's most lethal rushing attacks. For the New Orleans Saints, Drew Brees must be Drew Brees. The Saints defense needs to find a way to neutralize Adam Thielen, and both Mark Ingram and Alvin Kamara need to be on their A game. My prediction is that the New Orleans Saints wins 28-24. Next week, I'll be previewing the NFL Conference Round Playoffs. Disappointing players in fantasy basketball. Point guard, Lonzo Ball. Lonzo Ball entered the league with unrealistic expectations, so he was never going to live up to the expectations being a rookie in the league. Shooting guard, Avery Bradley. Avery Bradley is having a decent season, averaging 15.2 points, 1.2 steals on 42% shooting. However, he wasn't worth drafting as high as he was drafted. Small forward, Gordon Hayward. Unfortunately for Gordon Hayward and his fantasy owners, he got injured his first game of the season, and it's likely going to be out for the rest of the year. Power forward, Nerlens Noel. Nerlens Noel averaged 4 points and 4 rebounds before getting injured. He has been a major disappointment for fantasy owners. Center, Rudy Gobert. Rudy Gobert is having a pretty solid season so far, averaging 11.6 points, 9.6 rebounds, and 2.3 blocks, but that is not good enough production for being a first-round pick. Next week, I'll be talking about impact rookies in fantasy basketball. In the next podcast, I'll be talking about the Las Vegas Golden Knights season, I'll be previewing the NFL Conference Round Playoffs, and I'll also be talking about impact rookies in fantasy basketball.